Hey everybody, it's Brother Brett Potts with another episode of Pray for Japan. Today we're going to talk about the prefecture of Tochigi. Tochigi has a population of 1,943,000 souls. It has three towns with no churches. And our missionary ratio is 121,493 to 1. So the need is big in this prefecture for missionaries and evangelists and preachers to take the gospel and take it to the people of Tochigi. Tochigi has many hot springs and scenic spots that it is known for, and Tochigi actually has a very odd weather pattern. It has some drastic seasonal climates and daily temperature fluctuations according to the Pray for Japan prayer guide. So even though it has these weather changes and it has this kind of difficult climate, there is actually very little risk to natural disasters in the prefecture of Tochigi. So one of the other interesting things about Tochigi is the fact that it has Toshogu Shrine. And Toshogu Shrine is a shrine built to honor the samurai shogun Tokugawa Ieyasu, who's responsible for the whole unifying of Japan. And during this imperial time of Japan, this day at a warring states period, and Tokugawa Ieyasu is the shogun responsible for unifying Japan under one national kind of government, underneath himself as shogun. And Tokugawa Ieyasu is one of the most revered heroes and historical figures in Japanese history. Now, when his shrine was moved permanently, the whole area of Tochigi became kind of a sacred area for Japanese to revere and worship this shogun of Japan. And ancestor worship still plays a big part in Japan, and ancestor worship definitely plays a deep role in this shrine and in this place. So Toshogu Shrine is just a very interesting religious spot for the Japanese in Tochigi Prefecture. So the first thing that we can pray for today is that we want to pray that Japanese would meet Jesus through radio ministries and through live stream ministries from the churches in Japan. This is a big way that we can get the gospel across out to people in Japan that we can't reach to normally, being inside of one prefecture. The broadcast can go from another prefecture and reach the hearts, minds, and souls of Japanese that aren't even in the same prefecture as our missionaries, and touch their hearts and help them know who Jesus is. The second thing that we want to pray for is missionary training schools. There are many places in the Japanese islands that our missionaries are using and trying to train another generation of missionaries to reach the Japanese and reach the people that need to hear his word. And what we want to do is pray that God blesses these ministries and blesses these people as they reach into the lives and hearts of these young Christians, that they would instill a burden and a passion to reach the Japanese and to reach those that need to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. Another thing that we want to pray for is the Christian schools, and this is becoming a growing trend as we move into our prefectures, is to pray for these Christian schools, because these students are the future of Japan, and we want to build a future that has hope and a future that has a solid foundation in Christ. And we just want the Lord to touch on these students in these Christian schools and to help them grow and help them have an understanding and a knowledge of who he is. We just want the gospel to be spread through these students and through their schools, that they would just touch and they would move on the lives of others and impact them for Jesus Christ. Next thing we want to pray for is Tanuma Town. And this town is a fairly unchurched town within the Tochigi Prefecture. And we want to pray that there would be missionaries, evangelists, church planters that would feel the pull of God on their hearts and would feel the call of God in their lives to move and touch on this town and to go and plant churches, training centers, preaching points, prayer stations that would just open up this prefecture to the gospel of Jesus. The fifth thing that we want to pray for today is for the 21 unchurched villages and towns that used to be part of bigger cities. And they had mergers with other cities, and they joined together. And these towns need the gospel. They need someone to touch and reach into their hearts and minds of the residents there and let them know who Jesus is, and that he cares for them, and that he loves them, and that he wants to have a relationship with them, and that he wants to put hope into their lives. Last thing I want to mention, and I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time with this, is I plan on releasing a video doing an official statement on this coronavirus that's going around the world. And the thing about this is that it generates a lot of fear and a lot of anxiety and a lot of uncertainty. And Hope for Japan Ministries was named Hope for Japan for a reason. We want to promote hope. We want to promote that there is hope in Jesus. There is hope for this nation. There is hope for any nation, and there is hope for the world. If we trust in God, He'll get us through this. And God is still a healer. God is still capable. He's still going to provide. He's still going to do the things that He promised He would do, because He promised in His Word, and God does not go back on His Word. As always, thanks for joining us, guys, on this week's video of Praying for Japan. Next week is going to be the prefecture of Gunma. And remember to like and share this video. Get the word out there. Let people know that these prefectures need Jesus, that Japan needs Jesus, and that we can help by praying and by just supporting the ministries that are there. Thank you, and God bless.